We specialize in creating mobile apps for the entertainment industry.
Go to bvmobileapps.com, click Get Started Now, create your account, choose your package, upload your content, and click Submit. BV Mobile Apps. Make it easy. Make it mobile.
Oh, yeah. The Beat Break not only has exclusive music, but also exclusive interviews like this.
Except no substitutes.
Good morning. Welcome back to the Beat Break Morning Show. The architect here is Sean Garvey, DJ Rollo, and Star Kells. Make sure to follow us everywhere at Beat Break Radio, Facebook, Twitter, and on Instagram. This hour is brought to you by BV Mobile Apps. Yes, folks, I am drinking margarita this morning for this great occasion. From Enter the 36 Chambers to now Plant Grants, which is a grant program that promotes plant-based eating, we have the iconic, the legend, the god himself, RZA, on the line to talk more about it. Good morning, RZA. How are you?
Peace, 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 peace. Good morning to you, yo. Got margarita? Okay.
Hey, man, you know, hey, I'm trying to live a more of a healthier vegan lifestyle. I'm leaning towards that, but, you know, I got to still have my vices at the same time.
You got to have your special vitamins.
That part. Yeah, man. So let's go ahead and get right into it. From my understanding, RZA, you have been a vegan since 1997. What motivated you to get into the vegan lifestyle at that time?
Just really being health conscious about what was going into my body, realizing that nothing needed to die in order for me to live. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I just had like some type of common sense knowledge that hit me up that was like, yo, a cow weighs 1,500 pounds and a bull weighs up to 2,000 pounds of pure muscle. And they could move tons and all they do is eat grass. Right?
Right.
And we thought that we gotta eat them in order for us to live. Didn't really make sense. So, you know, it wasn't a quick stop. It was more like I stopped doing red meat for a year, then I stopped doing chicken and turkey for a year, and then I stopped doing fish, and I kept gradually progressing myself to this layoff of eating dead animals, you know what I mean? Mm. And then that led also getting rid of cheese and butter in my life, you know, the mucus in your body that's caused by cheese and butter and all that just became consciously unhealthy for me, you know what I mean? But it was tough.
Yeah.
It was hard to find good food, you know?
Yeah. You know, I've been coming across so many people, RZA, nowadays that are on the vegan lifestyle. They've been on it for maybe about 5 years, 10 years or more. And I think that's a sign to me to let me know, Sean, you may want to reconsider this vegan lifestyle thing. It's so many people that are passing away, dying from dietary issues, cancer, and then, of course, COVID is still happening. And people's like, yo, I gotta cut out some of what I'm putting into my system. Do you think with all the stuff that's happening nowadays, people dying from cancer, COVID, and things of that sort, is that the reason why people are moving towards being vegan?
I mean, yes, health conscious. Your health is your wealth. You know what I mean? And people realizing that some of the myths that we was taught as kids, you know, eat 3 meals a day and make sure you got some chicken, fish, and steak in it and some milk. That was really, you know, that's antiquated information. And people are paying attention to their bodies. You know, it says you are what you eat. You know what I mean? And I'm glad to see that it's growing. And it's really growing in the Black community as well, which is so positive. You know, we grew up in a community where our diet was soul food. And soul food is basically, is a heavily meat-based diet. And not only is it a heavily meat-based diet, it's also a lot of bad parts of meat. Also, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
So, but it was good. It came out of necessity, of course. Right? We had to eat to live, right? Mm-hmm. But now that you know you're conscious, we're moving to a new world, and also the flavors of food is now better, right? What I mean by that is that you can actually have a soul food diet without meat. You know, there's a beautiful place up in Harlem that's called Seasoned Vegan. And they specialize in soul food, you know. Brenda Bina, who's who's a head chef there and owns it.
Yeah.
She first of all, she grew up in New Orleans, so she know how to cook. Right?
Facts.
And she has 32 different seasonings that she used to create vegan crawfish. And people line up for her food around the corner in Harlem, especially those peanut butter cookies that she makes. You know, she makes peanut butter chocolate chip cookie that tastes vegan. You know what I mean? So people, restaurants and are figuring out recipes. You know, we have this thing called Plant Grants that I partnered with VioLife on. And the idea was, COVID did hurt our community, right? And a lot of restaurants were suffering. So Plant Grants, we were able to give 5 restaurants a grant to keep them open and to help give them an economic boost. And, that's of course Seasoned Vegan being one in Harlem, Supreme Oasis Bakery in Delhi, out of Philadelphia. We was able to do the Plant Power Cafe Juice Bar in Chattanooga, Tennessee, as well as my man from Houston, the vegan pizza in Houston, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And can't forget my homegirls on Louisiana who we blessed as well. So point being made is that these recipients was able to get economics to help them get through the tough times of COVID and also start adding plant-based items on the menu. You don't have to be a cold turkey automatic turnaround.
Right.
You could gradually make your way into it, you know? We have Chef Lamel Dura from Compton Vegan, who's a genius in business, as well as doing very successful in his vegan business. We also brought him on board, and he's mentoring these restaurants, because, he's mentoring them in business practice as well as diet practices and how to make the best dishes. And we also have Chef Larissa Chandler Baker, Miss Baker, who she's out of Chicago. And she has a restaurant called Can't Believe It's Not Meat. She's like,
yeah.
I can't believe it's not butter. But can't believe it's not meat.
Yeah.
And once again, she's mentoring, helping our team of recipients just further themselves.
Yeah. Explain to me something, the process. What was the process like to issue and to give these businesses grants to start the plant-based vegan thing? Because I know it had to be like a very lengthy process to get $20,000, I believe it is, $20,000 in grant money?
Yeah. Well, VioLife, a really cool company. They actually started a few friends. They started about 30 years ago. And, they did research to try to find out a better way to make cheese because they didn't want to, they didn't want to sacrifice cheese in life based on some traditional beliefs. I partnered with them, this year, 2021, because first of all, we share the same philosophy to make plant-based eating more delicious and affordable and available for all. And we sent out, an invitation for restaurants to apply and tell us their story on, why do they deserve the grant? Why, what is their struggle they're going through based on the COVID? And when we looked at all of them, we a lot came in, of course, but we ended up choosing 5. And we chose them based on different reasons. Every restaurant wasn't a vegan restaurant, but wow, it was a restaurant that was the pillar of the community, know what I mean? And we wanted to keep that pillar of that community alive. So the one great story though of I'm going to tell you about a Meek's vegan pizza down in Houston. Demetrius Walker, the owner of it, we couldn't resist his story. His story was, here's a guy who lived in New York, loved New York pizza, moves to Houston, has a son, and his son is not interested in a vegan lifestyle, but Demetrius became interested in it. And he wanted to find a way to introduce his son to a vegan lifestyle. And their favorite pastime dish was pizza. So he worked on it and made New York style pizza in Houston, but all vegan. And his son loved it, and it inspired him to go, you know, start with a food truck and start building up to, you know, he has a restaurant and he's doing well, and you know, and he's one of the winners, one of the recipients of the grant. And I met this brother, man, and man, he's a special guy because his tenacity, his energy, his dedication to make his life better, make his son's life better, and make his community better, it exudes out of him. Right. And you know, so he's one of, that's why he's one of the recipients of the grants. We wanted to, you know, help those who also are gonna spread the help, spread the love, spread the chi, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. I'm loving it. In our communities these days, especially urban communities, all you see are fast food restaurants. All you see is just meat-based restaurants. And it's almost crazy, RZA. Like, you got to drive maybe 30 minutes to 45 or an hour out of the area or the city that you're in just to get to a vegan-based restaurant. I know we have a few in Atlanta, and you know me, I'm a Southern boy, so I come from the city of soul food and macaroni cheese and all that great stuff, man, but I feel like we need more vegan restaurants in the area because, like I said earlier, you know, our people are dying in massive numbers, and I think that's a great thing that you're doing by giving out these grants to people that need them. And the interesting thing you said is, you know, the meat base, they used to be meat based, but now they're becoming more and more vegan based. Do you think, question for you, do you think there needs to be a balance of still having the meat based restaurants and the vegan restaurants? Or do you think, in your own personal opinion, there needs to be just nothing but vegan restaurants all throughout the board?
No, I think, look, I think it's gradual, you know? I think that, first of all, I think that if you go to any restaurant, right, I think restaurants have a balance. So it should be, first and foremost, if there's a steakhouse that specializes in steak, you know, they should consider having some vegan dishes on their menu because the vegan consumer is growing. You know what I mean? I don't think the vegan restaurants should include meat on their menu. I think they've evolved past that. But I do think those who have not got on that evolutionary track, you know, they don't have to change their whole formula, close their doors. But just the same way as I did it personally, I didn't just overnight become this. It took years, you know what I mean? Yeah. But I do think that I should get on the road. You know, you're talking about, you know, in our community, there's only, you know, fast food restaurants and meat-based restaurants all around the corner, all in front of us. Then you got to go, like you said, 30 minutes to find some wholesome food and some vegan-based food. You know, we need more places like Vegans on the Run. Vegans on the Run is ran by three generations of women, right?
Right.
Including Dr. Jocelyn Mardi Pickens, her daughter Jaylen, her mother Linda, right, and her sister Dr. Kimberly down in Louisiana. They're in the black community. They're in that community called The Bottom. That's in Shreveport, Louisiana, right?
Right.
And they also felt like, yo, why is nothing healthy here in our neighborhoods? And so they opened up Vegans Run and Run, and they will deliver it to you. Right? And so maybe they should franchise that out so that you don't got to drive the 30 minutes, then bring it to your house.
Wow. Like DoorDash or something.
Yeah, DoorDash it out, yo. And they, you know, they got mac and cheese on their on their menu, but they also got one of their most popular dishes. They got vegan gumbo.
Mm-mm.
Now, I've had vegan gumbo before, bro.
Yeah,
in fact, I became vegan before I had real gumbo. But I always like I was in Louisiana, like, I never really had gumbo, and then the vegan gumbo came.
Ooh.
And I had my assistant. He's from Louisiana.
Yeah,
he's actually from the Ninth Ward, you know, and he's been with me now for 4 years. But he tasted the vegan gumbo, and he was like, "Yo, OG, it's good.
Oh man,
it's good as my mama's."
Oh man, I gotta get that vegan gumbo, man. You know, I've been. Yeah, you know what's so crazy? Like, my favorite food, and I tell people this, my favorite food is vegetarian pizza. And people would not believe, like, your favorite food is vegetarian pizza. I would have thought that you being from the South, your favorite food is chicken and collard greens and all that, you know, all that other meat stuff. But vegetarian pizza, and I just like, yo, it tastes good. I mean, actually, in my personal opinion, it tastes way more better than the meat pizza, you know, like your pepperoni pizza and all the other stuff. I mean, this vegetarian stuff would change your life.
Yeah, man. Look, your health is your wealth. You know what I mean? Take it day by day. You know, I know some of your listeners may be saying, hold on, man, I ain't letting go of my fried chicken. Yo, me personally, yo, bro, I used to knock out 30 chicken wings. All right? I sit down, knock out 30 of those.
Woo!
You know, I never forget the day I was up the wing 27 one day, and my teeth kind of hit the bone. Ooh. And my mom was like, yo, G, you eating a dead bird. I said, wait a minute, I'm eating a dead bird. in New York, and all the pigeons was starting to disappear.
Yeah.
I was like, what's going on? So my mom was like, yo, I don't need this. You know what I mean? And then I thought that I wouldn't find something that tastes as good. Now, it's so many things that taste even better. I don't even get, because, you know, I don't know if you eat chicken, but sometimes there's like a smell, a death blood smell in it. You know what I mean?
Right.
And really, most food we eat is based on the seasoning. And now that the texture and there's certain vegetables and certain way that you can mold vegetables to have a texture, batter it up and deep fry it, yo.
Yeah.
And you'll never miss the flavor of chicken, man. And these restaurants are doing that these days, bro. So you don't have to think that you got to sacrifice flavor, texture, or protein. That was another big myth. Oh, how are you going to get protein? First of all, it's more protein in five pistachios. Then full of meat. You know what I mean? There's protein all in chickpeas, lentils. These things are highly protein. Oh, well, how am I getting my omega if I don't eat no fish? Omega oil, son, slice open that avocado. You're going to get omega oil, fatty acids, everything that's going to be even better for your body without the digestion of, it's harder to digest meat in all reality.
Man.
They say the average American might be sitting on, you know, 15, 20 pounds of undigested meat through his intestinal system. A lot of brothers don't know their intestines, Z, is like, I think your small intestine might be like 60 feet long, bro.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. I mean,
you know, at the feet 20 mark.
Yeah.
There's some old steak in there that's been sitting there. You know what I mean? Like, undigestible, because remember, your body got to break things down to the molecular level.
Yeah.
In order for it to be absorbed into the body. You know what I'm saying? And I even argue with people that, yo, G, don't think that sometimes it has to be broken down to the atomic level. And that's a whole nother scientific thing that I'm not going to get into, but
right,
you're going to be conscious to that. It's just like when we breathe in air, we're breaking down the oxygen, hydrogen, neon, argon, all these gases is in our atmosphere, but it's the oxygen that's sustaining us, and those molecules, those atoms separate and go where they need to go. But that's a whole other thing. But
yeah,
anyway, I'll pass you the mic back.
No, it's good. It's all good. You breaking the science down, especially for those that are still hesitant on turning their lifestyle over to veganism. But I know we only got a few minutes with you. For those that are tuning in, we're talking to the RZA, Wu-Tang, Sean Garvey, the architect, the Beat Break Morning Show, as we're talking about plant grants, a grant program that promotes plant-based eating. What do you have to say to those that are saying, like, yo, I mean, I want to go into the vegan lifestyle, but it's too expensive? Like I said, you have easy access, right, to restaurants, to the meat-based restaurants. They're cheaper. But the vegan, and I've been to some places where it was like hella expensive. So what do you have to say to those that feel like, oh man, it's too expensive?
Well, your health is your wealth, right?
Right.
You want to eat a $5 burger that's going to decay you quicker, or eat a $10 meal that's going to give you more strength, vitality, and enhance your life. So there's no price on health. In all reality, if you ain't got health, you ain't got nothing. But I think it's gonna look, it'll become more economically accessible as more of us join it, right?
Right.
So since you know, since it's something that takes, you know, like you can't just get it fast, right?
Right.
It takes more of us to join it. The reason why you can pay 99 cents for a burger at some of these places, G, is because they're selling so many burgers, so many places. They got excess burgers, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So once we build up as a community, plant-based living in these restaurants, the prices will drop down. But personally, I'm not going to say personally, because I'm going to say, well, Liz, you can afford it, but you can afford it. I'm gonna say, but still, even if I didn't have economics support in my life, I would still advise anyone to eat healthy, man. Don't go for it because it's a dollar. You know what I mean?
Right.
You know. Yeah. So anyway.
Yeah.
And look, and break the stereotype. It's actually the fastest growing vegan consumers in America right now is Black Americans, and so we are on that path. And I just want to tell everyone out there who's thinking of getting on that path, we support you. There's other hip hop artists that's also in this field now. Right. And it's most important, we're saying, yo, we are just trying to bring more health and more knowledge to our community about how to eat healthy.
Yeah, education. It starts with educating the people that are not aware. And that's what we do here, especially on the morning show. So really quick, RZA, because I know you got to go. Go ahead and break down the 5 Black-owned restaurants selected to receive funding. Yeah, you know, we got to hear this, man. Like, who are some of the restaurants?
Names. Okay, once again, we had Vegans on the Run out of Louisiana. We had Meek's Vegan Pizza in Houston. We had Seasoned Vegan up in Harlem. We had Supreme Oasis Bakery and Deli. Deli, that's out in Philadelphia. And we had Plant Power Cafe and Juice Bar in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Mm. Those are all of our recipients. We're happy that we can help them and happy that they're helping their communities, man. And thank you for having me on the air, man.
Hey, man, congratulations to those 5 major restaurants. They're now major now that RZA is in it. And for more information, how can people learn more information about the plant grant?
You can get more information on the plant grant. Go into biolife.com/plant grants, and you can look up there. And look, we did it now. We're planning on continuing this. So, you know, these 5 restaurants have got it, and we'll still be here to help more and build this up. And Biolife is committed, not just because I'm part of it. They're committed to continue this, even if the RZA gets busy and do something else. We're committed to trying to spread plant-based living and gradually, you know, as I said before, make a better tomorrow, make a better world, yo, one step at a time.
Absolutely, man. Well, definitely keep doing what you're doing, RZA. Congratulations on the plant grant. Now I'm going to be fully vegan. I'm taking it one day at a time. I'm taking it one day at a time. But that's part of my New Year's resolution, is to go full vegan by January 2022. That's what's up. And also,
I was going to say, once again, I just want to repeat it one more time, that WW Plant Grant, it's BioLife is the company, but it's www.plantgrants.com. You have to go skip the BioLife part and go right to that. And so the website is there.
Plantgrants.com. I love it. And also, congratulations on the Emmy nominated series Wu-Tang and American Saga. Hey, man, look, I watched that. Let me tell you really quick, RZA. I'm so addicted to that show. I watch it in between breaks when I do the morning show and the radio show. I watch it and I watch it again and again and again on demand. I feel like a season 3 is coming.
Thank you for watching, bro. Thank you for watching. And you know, the more people who watch and enjoy it, the more ratings and all that, and the more that will allow us to season 3. It's all about the numbers and TV business. But yeah, there's a lot of fans watching and enjoying the show, and I want to just thank you for being one of those fans, man. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much. It is on Hulu right now, and Hulu on demand. Wu-Tang and American Saga, the RZA, right here on the Beat Break Morning Show. Go get veganized. Thanks for coming on the morning show, RZA.
Thank you. Peace.
Absolutely. Peace. The RZA, exclusively right here on the Beat Break Morning Show with the architect Sean Garvey. For more information, go to plantgrants.com. That's plantgrants with an S.com. We want to thank Ted Berkey and VioLife for putting this interview together. And once again, this hour is brought to you by BV Mobile Apps. For more information, go to bvmobileapps.com. We got all that and more coming up right here on the Beat Break Morning Show with Sean Garvey, Star Kells, and DJ Rollin. Make sure to follow us on all your social media at Beat Break Radio.
Sean Garvey is the MC.
So respect the architect as I begin to build.
DJ Rollum is the DJ.
Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ.
And Star Kells fills you in on what's trending.
Hey, do anything for clout. Do anything for clout.
The Beat Break Morning Show. Tune in and tap in.
Life moves fast, and if you want to keep up, you've got to get mobile, no matter what you do or how you define yourself.
Program director.
I am an author.
Artist, musician.
Senior producer extraordinaire.
I'm a radio host.
A motivational speaker.
Internet show host.
Executive producer.
Owner. President.
Whatever you want to call me.
BV Mobile Apps has been so helpful to me.
We are in the new era, the new age of technology.
The world is mobile right now.
To try to compete with the bigger boys, you have to have a mobile app.
The mobile app has definitely added credibility to my brand.
Because I can cater to my readers. I can cater to my listeners.
It helps get the word out about your company or your brand.
It's extremely important for that information to be accessible to people while they are on the go.
So it'll go out to all of my social media. And it'll come directly to your phone.
Since I had the mobile app,
a lot more advertisers, we are getting a lot more sponsors.
7 tracks between booking studio time, I've generated thousands in revenue.
We specialize in creating mobile apps for the entertainment industry.
Go to bvmobileapps.com, click Get Started Now, create your account, choose your package, upload your content, and click Submit.
Definitely put your trust in BV Mobile Apps.
Because they deliver.
Because these guys are professional.
BV Mobile Apps is dope.
BV Mobile Apps. Make it easy. Make it mobile.